Welcome, friends, to another edition of Tiffenbox TV. I am your host, Seishu, and as a portrait photographer, I'm always looking for wonderful teachers, resources for me and for you. And one of them happens to be Joy Vertz, who's with us today. Joy is a Milwaukee photographer. She runs a business in Milwaukee. It's a portrait business. But she's also a phenomenal teacher. She's got a couple of wonderful courses. One is on pricing, and the other one is really about figuring out your business, you know, from start to finish, really. Joy, thanks for joining me today.
Hey, I'm so excited. Thanks for having me.
Let's jump right into it because, you know, people want to know what is it that, or how is it that you define a successful business?
Well, I think first and foremost is a couple things. One, I think you need to have a business that works with your lifestyle and where the business is not running you. Because that is one of the biggest problems I see with photographers is they work nonstop. They can't separate themselves from their phones. Their clients are contacting them night and day, and they're responding. So just a little clue, don't text your clients because that gives them the little, you know, the inkling that they can reach you at any time. So number one, make sure that your business doesn't run you. And number two, make sure that it's profitable. Because, you know, a lot of people don't have any clue about their pricing, we're creatives. And for the most part, photographers have a hard time wrapping their heads around the numbers of a business. And at the end, you know, if they're able to pay themselves a little bit, sometimes they're happy or they're, you know, they're kind of struggling and not really getting where they want to be. But, you know, this is a business and you need to be making the amount of money that you want to be making. Otherwise, why do it?
Indeed.
So make sure you're happy. And make sure that you're making money. Otherwise, go work for somebody else where you're going to have a lot less stress and a lot less, you know, overhead and work.
Indeed. Perhaps the cornerstone of making money is pricing. And this is a topic that you are the queen of, really, because I think nobody knows pricing and nobody knows to teach pricing as well as you do. You have a course called Pain-Free Pricing. But from your experiences for working with photographers all around the country, what do you think is the stumbling block for photographers when it comes to pricing? Why is it that they cannot ever see themselves pricing at a higher rate than they feel for themselves? Like they always say, "Well, that's too much." Like, why do they do that?
Well, I think a lot of it comes down to confidence. And the confidence comes really from not understanding your numbers. And the thing is that most photographers aren't in this business to make, you know, gobs and gobs of money. You know, almost every single person that I talk to, they're not looking to make $300,000 a year and up. They're looking to make a very stable, fair salary. So really what you're doing by being a business owner is not trying to gouge your clients, but we have so many expenses and so much time that goes into what we do. And if you don't value that time, you're not ever going to be able to pay yourself what you want to pay yourself. So the biggest mistake a lot of photographers make is that they will pay everybody else first, and then if they have money left over, they'll pay themselves. And I like to always teach it where you need to build in your dream budget. So you're going to build in your salary. You're going to build in all of your expenses for what you want to be able to spend in your business. And that's going to give you like an hourly rate that is what you need to be charging in order to make a fair profit. And, you know, the thing is that you can be profitable at a lot of different levels. I mean, we have people who, well, let's look at hair salons. I mean, I make this analogy a lot, but it's totally true.
Mm-hmm.
Where, you know, you have like a Supercuts or Cost Cutters, you know, where you can go in and get a $12 haircut. You have kind of the Aveda salons where you can get a $40 or $50 haircut. And you have the super high-end salons where you can get a $200 haircut. All those business models are profitable. The difference is that at the $200 level, you're going to be expecting a lot more service, a lot more handholding, a lot more fluff, if you will. And at the bottom end, you're going to be expecting to go in, get a haircut, and be done. Like, they might not even wash your hair. They're just going to wet it down, and you're out the door. And the thing is that a lot of photographers, they want to be that really high end. Like, they want to give their clients the fancy packaging and the the fluff and all the extra time, but they don't want to charge for it. So you need to make the decision of where you want to be in that mix. Do you want to be maybe more mid-range? And you can absolutely be, you know, profitable at that mid-range as well. You just need to then really concentrate on making sure you don't spend too much time with your clients or too much time on editing. And so you can trim out, expenses, and you can trim out time in other places to make sure that you're profitable, you know, across the board. What? Once you understand those numbers, I mean, it's more of a formula. It's not really, it's not anything that you need to make up. It's like, this is how much you want to make. This is how much your expenses are. And this is how much your product is. So this is how much you charge.
Simple enough, right?
It is simple. And once you understand it, you'll get it. And it'll give you that confidence to be able to explain it to your clients. So when a client calls and they're like, oh my gosh, why are you so much more expensive? You have the confidence to be able to explain how you're different. And, you know, one other thing is I think a lot of people get really tripped up talking about price with their clients. And the thing is that when you have that confidence, you're able to do it more effectively. But also, you know, I think that, I totally just lost my train of thought.
That's quite okay. That's quite okay. Let me ask you a follow up question though.
Yeah, sure.
You know, a lot of people not only are probably not as confident about mentioning or talking about price, but also from a very personal experience, my own situation, I was always reluctant to show my clients a price list of any kind when we first talk. Because I would always wanted them to fall in love with my work, perhaps fall in love with me, perhaps, you know, all these things were running through my brain. And I think for most consumers, they want to know what they're going to be really paying, I guess. And they want to know how it's going to affect the final products are going to affect their life. Right. So, and it comes down to figuring out how to present both of that. So what would you say to someone like me, you know, who in terms of the crafting of the photography, I have had no problems. But in terms of the business, it's always been like, when do I couch these words about pricing and products to my clients and say, hey, this is what I can offer you in terms of products or whatever for your home, so you can enjoy these photographs, you know, right? So yeah. What would you tell them?
Yes. Okay. So that's interesting because you saying that is what triggered my lost train of thought. I was thinking about competing on pricing.
Sure.
And, you know, a lot of people go right into it when somebody calls and they're like, okay, how much is a 8x10? And the thing is that unless you're going to compete on price, you're probably never going to win. And the only way that you're going to win when you compete on price is if you're the lowest price. And that's probably never going to happen unless you're maybe like a volume shooter, like a Schools or something like that. So it's really important to figure out what it is that you can compete on. Is it the best service? Is it the best quality? Is it really unique products? Is it making it really simple and efficient for your clients to come in and get a session really quickly? And everybody has a little different, you know, kind of value proposition. So when a client calls, you know, I want you to keep that in mind. Like, what is the thing that makes you stand out? You know, at our studio, we're not the most expensive. We're not the least expensive by any means. We're probably in the upper 25% of, you know, studios in the area as far as cost. We actually have kind of a reputation of being pretty expensive. But what we found is that our pricing isn't that much more expensive than a lot of other people's. It's just that they tend to buy more than they had anticipated. So we have a reputation of being more expensive just because they have exceeded their own budget. And that's a testament to us, you know, that we're able to provide a great service.
Sure.
So when somebody calls and they're like, you know, ring, ring, hey, Joy, how much is an 8x10? I just simply say, I am so excited to answer all of your pricing questions, but let me just make sure we're on the same page. And let me ask you a few questions. And I'll go in and I'll start talking to them and I'll ask them follow-up questions like, okay, well, tell me about, you know, what you had in mind for this session. You know, who are we going to be photographing? Where do you envision these images going? Do you have a spot in your home that you're thinking? So now they're talking and they're giving me information about their family, and we might uncover that maybe this is you know, a milestone, or this is, you know, they just moved into a new home and they have this huge wall. Okay, well, obviously, if they have a huge wall, they're not even looking for 8x10s. The reason that they called and they asked about an 8x10 is because they didn't know what else to ask. They didn't know what our products are. They don't know what we have to offer. And they're trying to get an idea, and they don't know the right questions to ask. So by us being able to uncover more information, we are then able to, you know, go ahead and try to add some value. So we might find out that they have, you know, a wall that's 4 feet long, and it's one of those spots that they've always just been looking for something perfect. And I'll be like, okay, well, tell me about the furniture in there. Tell me about the colors. You know, tell me about, you know, your daughter. You said she's into dance. What if we created, you know, a painting that would go there? And they're like, oh my God, that would be perfect. So I'll be like, okay, well, you know, you said the room's blue. What if we put her in, you know, a cream colored tutu or whatever it would be? So we can now, as the artists, start having them envision. And once they have a vision of what it's going to look like, they are much more able to see spending the money. So now we've established not only the fact that we're great at what we do, we're going to give them service, it's going to be customizable, we are going to create something that's one of a kind, and those are the things that we excel on, and we've got them thinking beyond price. So I'm happy to then at that point say, well, based on our conversation, I can estimate that it's going to be approximately, you know, $1,400 to $2,200. You know, and here's how our sessions work. And then I go into our booking process. So I throw it out there, and then I just go right into the booking process. And a lot of times they're already so invested in the session at that point that it's not really an issue. Sometimes they'll be like, oh my gosh, that's way too much. And then we actually have an option where they can do more of a mini session. But what happens when we present our mini sessions is that they will often see the differences. So they're going to see that they don't get outfit changes. They don't get the full gamut of products. They don't get background changes. And so when we explain the differences, more often than not, the people will skip the mini session and see the value of going to a full session. So for us, getting people talking away from pricing, we are not at all afraid to talk about pricing, but we want to establish that value first.
Awesome. One of the things you also do is you teach a course called Photo Business Recharge. Uh-huh. Tell us a little bit about that course as well, so that people will understand the options. People can have options in terms of which one to go to.
Sure. Yeah. And they work really kind of hand in hand. PhotoBiz Recharge does have a module on pricing, but it's maybe like 15% of the amount of pricing. It'll get you a really good start, and you'll start to definitely understand your numbers, where the pricing class is super in-depth and talks about theory and, you know, collections and how to present your price and how to design your price list and make sure that you truly understand it. So PhotoBiz Recharge is 19 different lessons, and it's all the best things that have worked for our business. So these are all things that are tried and true. And what it is it's basically taking like the 19 things that have made me the most money over the years, the things that I've, you know, really like finessed and figured out all the problems so you don't have to deal with it because I've already done it. Mm-hmm. And I love action items. So the goal of this class was to, you know, present these different ideas. For example, it talks about how to do a headshot event, how to do a flash sale, which is something that, you know, occasionally we need money, and so we have to just do it. And it'll talk about the ways to do it effectively so that you're not killing future sales, and also not you know, cheapening your brand. Mm-hmm. It talks about ways to do sales and walks you through a session from start to finish. So it really is action items, and you don't have to do the class all in order. You can actually even skip around a little bit, but you can watch one of the videos independently and then take that item and go and implement it in an afternoon, and it'll be done and you're ready to go.
Awesome.
So we give you all the tools, all the templates and everything so that you can be like, okay, let's work on, website SEO. And so you can watch the video, learn about it, and go implement the ideas. Now, it's not going to teach you every single thing about SEO because obviously that could be a whole class in its own,
Sure.
but it's going to teach you some definite things that most photographers are not doing that are simple to implement that will definitely help.
Excellent, excellent. One of the things you told me before we started recording is that you are coming to Connecticut thanks to CTPPA.
I'm so excited.
I'm excited because I live in Connecticut, so this is phenomenal. We get to finally meet, but let's talk about your presentation for CTPPA. What is it that they're bringing you in for? And give us a hint, give us a few hints, I guess, on what we could possibly learn during your course here.
Yeah, so my presentation for Connecticut is going to be 10 ways to make more money in 2016. So it's going to be the 10 action items that you are going to be able to go home with and implement within a few days. And, some of the things might be kind of simple things, like this is a good way to do customer service, or, here's one way that we brought in 10 extra bookings. Just by going home and doing, this particular, item or activity. And so I don't want to give away too many secrets because you guys all need to come, but bring a notebook and be ready to take lots of notes because when I speak, I like to give lots and lots of action items that people will go home and do. It's interesting because one of the things that I have people do when I'm speaking is when you're taking notes, I have people circle the items that they're actually going to go home and do right away because I
Awesome.
think if you don't go home and actually implement it, it doesn't ever get done. And by circling the items that you're going to go do, it is a good way to go back through your notes and just kind of easily find the things that like really seem to hit home with you. And I have lots of people that will text me or, well, not text me, but Twitter me or email me later. And they'll be like, oh, I had, eight items and I was able to go home and get them all done within, 2 or 3 days. So I love hearing stories like that. And I'm so excited to be sharing some things that are going to be easy to see, to implement and see some good results with right away.
Excellent, excellent. Yeah, and this is April 25th in Connecticut. We'll have more details in the blog post below, but I wanted to make sure that my friends at CTPPA and the members of CTPPA understand that this is what they can expect when you do come to talk to us here in Connecticut. It's phenomenal. What one thing would you recommend? One thing that you'd recommend photographers do in 2016 to be successful. We started out talking about success and how you define success. I'd love to know what you would recommend, one thing that photographers can do right off the bat that will get them on the path to being of success.
Yeah, I guess I would do a reassessment of the thing that brought you the biggest pain in 2015. And if, for example, if your biggest pain was you felt like your clients ran your life, then you need to make a concrete goal to work on, that work-life boundaries balance. If your biggest pain was you looked at your balance sheet and you weren't making enough money, then you know that the biggest thing you need to work on is pricing. Pricing seems to be a big topic for a lot of photographers. Interesting little tidbit. So the last 3 times I spoke in person, at WPPI, for example, lots and lots of people in the room, and I started my presentation by asking people to raise their hand if they consistently pay themselves. And less than about 3% of the people in that room raised their hand, which blew my mind.
Oh, wow.
It blew my mind because there was a wide variety of people, photographers who had been in business multiple years. So I really think pricing is a huge thing for a lot of photographers because they just don't understand it. Numbers aren't really fun. Well, they're fun for me because I love that stuff, but numbers aren't fun for most people. So I think it's one of those things that kind of goes by the wayside. And often I hear, well, Joy, I'll take your pricing class once I get people coming in the door because I need money. And I was like, okay, well, that's kind of like, for, you know, horse before the cart, because you don't want people coming in the door and doing all this work if they're not profitable.
Right.
So get your pricing in line first, and if it's not, that should be your number one thing to work on for 2016. If your pricing's not, you know, working for you, get that all under control, because then everything else, you're going to have more money coming in, and everything else is going to fall into place.
Awesome. Awesome advice. As always, Joy, it's always a pleasure to interact with you. I know we've always talked on Facebook forums and
Yeah.
Twitter and things like that. It's great to connect with you. And I'm looking forward to your presentation with the CTPPA on
So fun.
April 25th. It's going to be amazing. Thank you again for joining us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
Take care. Bye.
Too. Bye.